So how was your morning class and evening class? How are sessions going? Morning and second session? Good? Okay, so we are going to start DBMS. And today in this class, we will see only basics. Okay, we will start with zero. And then we will move to next complex concepts. Okay, so what we will do is, we will not explain actually definitions of database management system on database. We will directly start from the ER model. Okay, from the database design. Okay, so this is the syllabus for this course that we have discussed. Let's see one more time. Integrity constraints. And ER model, which we are going to discuss today. Then we will see schema refinement. And normalization. Then we have transaction. And concurrency control. Then we will see queries. That is SQL, relational algebra, and tuple relational calculus. And we have domain relational calculus also, and this has been removed from this syllabus. Okay. Then we have indexing and file structure. So the weightage of these topics are, in last 4 to 5 years, they have asked questions from ER model also. That is, they ask the question that is specifically the minimization of ER model, mapping ER model to tables. Okay, so most of the students face the problem in this topic. That is, how we map the ER model to our tables. Okay, what are the constraints on which we need to work? Okay. So at least 2 to 3 marks from this topic, and always from the normalization. 4 marks. Okay, transaction and concurrency control. This is not asked every year. They actually ask the concept of transaction and concurrency control after every year. Okay, in the alternate years. If you will see the papers, you will find a question, not every year, but after 1 year. Okay, like this. So you can take the weightage 2 to 3 marks. And queries, they also ask 4 to 5 marks. And then indexing. 2 to 3 marks. So this is the weightage of these topics. So we will start with the integrity constraints and ER model. So first we will talk about the database design. Okay. So how we design the database? We design the database in the levels, just like the software engineering. How we develop a software? First we gather the requirements, then we do the designing, then coding, or you can say implementation, and then testing and maintenance. So same thing is done in the database design. When we design the database, what we do is, first we take the requirements, then we model the requirements, and then we map the requirements to some models, and then that model is implemented. Okay, so what is the process of designing a database? So we are designing the database in 3 levels. So first what we do is, we take the requirements and we do the conceptual schema, conceptual design. Conceptual design means you will go to the users, or you can say client, and client will discuss all his requirements with you. Okay, clients will talk only in terms of, let's say, nouns or things. He will say, these will be my tables, these are the employees, and these are the relations between employees, or you can say departments. So department is a thing, employee is a noun. So then you have to show that, they will say that this is the relationship between employee and department. Let's say they will say, in requirement analysis, every department should have an employee, and one employee may be may be connected to only one departments, or you can say one department can have many employees. So from the requirement analysis, you will make a ER diagram. Okay, so in a ER diagram, by looking at the requirement analysis phase, what you will do is that if the client is saying that every department should have an employee, this means the relationship should be from the department to employee is total. Total means mandatory. Okay, relationship can be optional or mandatory. All these things should be identified in the requirement analysis phase. So after taking the conceptual schema and then modeling the requirements in terms of ER diagrams, next what we need to do is we need to map these ER diagrams to some relational model. Okay, so famous, which is most used relational model is, that is in form of tables, or you can say RDBMS. So we use the RDBMS in this second stage to map the tables, to map the ER diagrams to tables. Okay, this is one of the topics in our course that we will see. Representation. How to represent the ER diagram into tables? Okay, into tables. Why we are hiding the information? Why we are hiding this information, and why we are not taking the information, the requirements from the client in form of tables? Because client may not be aware of the internal details, like what are tables, what is the relation, what is key, all these things. Client is not actually aware of these. Client only know one thing, that we require these things, and he can express his requirements in form of things or relations. Okay, so this is not visible to the client. Okay, this is only visible to developer. Then what we will do is low level implementation means, now you have tables, and in this table you have entered the data. Now you have to store this table into the hard disk. Okay, you have to store the tables into the hard disk. Let's say you have a database of 4 GB, and in this 4 GB you have some tables, and tables are in the form of records. So you can simply say database is a collection of records. Okay, actually tables are a collection of records, but because database is a collection of tables, so you can say your database is a collection of records, and records are stored in the form of blocks. Whenever you map any file to hard disk, they are stored in the form of blocks. So finally you have to store the file, your table, into the hard disk, so that will be stored in terms of blocks. So how you will store these blocks into hard disk? This will be done by, you will use any method like B-tree or B+tree. So it will depend which in case of implementation, which technique you are using. It will be independent of representation, or representation will be independent of conceptual schema. So on the conceptual schema, you can use other methods like object-oriented method. Okay, ER method is one of the methods, but this is most popular used, and this is in our syllabus. So we will discuss only ER diagram. In this form, in this phase, we will use relational model. Relational model means, we will map the ER diagrams to tables, in the form of tables. And table is also known as relation. You can say simply table is a relation. And then is at this level, we will use B-trees and B+trees. So always remember, to store the data in RAM, we use the binary search trees. To store the data in hard disk, we use the B-trees and B+trees. Okay, so we have some terms in ER diagram. We will see what are these. So as you can see, in conceptual level, we will use ER model. Then we will map these AR models to relations, or you can say we will use relational model, and then implementation. Okay, so designing phase will go like this. First we will see AR diagrams, then you will see relational model, then we will see implementation. So complete syllabus of database management system actually is around these three things: database design, database management system, and database design. So database management system is actually a collection of programs to access the database. Okay, that's why we say that DBMS is interface between user and database. Okay, so in DBMS we have all these things. So we will see first ER diagrams, that is conceptual level. Okay, So ER diagram means, so first we will see some basic terminologies, then we will move to keys and all these things, integrity constants. Okay, so in ER diagram we have entities, then we will have some attributes, and then some relationships. Entities means anything, you can say things like person. Okay, person is a entity type, person is a entity type, and Rahul is a entity. Okay, if I say entity type means all the entities which have same attributes. For example, person means a person can have name, age, identifier, all these things. So entity type is a collection of entities. So person is actually an entity type. Okay, and when you say entity means a real world entity, a real world object. If you say employee, for example, I am an employee. So I have some employee ID, employee name, employee age, all these things. If you say attributes, so attributes are actually the properties. Properties means what are your properties? You can say attributes. Properties means attributes. Attributes like all these things, name, age, all these things. Okay, relationship means association. Association of one person to another person, or you can say one entity to another entity, or in simple terms, person to thing, thing to person, or person to person. All these associations are known as relationships. Okay, so in ER diagram, what we are doing is we are trying to model the complete requirements in one diagram in which we are showing which entities are related and how we are actually managing the entities. Okay. So what is schema and instance? Do we know what is schema and instance? Instance and schema. For example, I have a schema, that is person schema, and person may have a ID. Let's say this person is employee, name and age. This is known as the schema. Okay, this is schema. Whatever the name of table and what are the attributes, collection of attributes and name of the table, or you can say heading of the table, is known as the schema. Instance means actual values. For example, employee ID is 12, name is ABC, age is 20. So this is instance of this table, of this schema. Instance means at a particular instance, what are the values of a particular entity. So this is also, this known as instance, and this is schema. Okay, so these are the basic terms in database management system. Then we have attributes. The types of attributes. Okay, we know the type of attributes. Okay, why I'm teaching all these things, some of the students have requested that we want to study from the zero. So I will take first lecture from the zero and then we will move. So what are the attributes? What are the kind of attributes? Simple and then single valued, then okay, I am making a entity and you need to identify the types of attributes. Let's say this is employee entity and I have some attributes of this entity, and entity is represented in form of rectangle. Okay. This is my entity, and the attributes are like this. Which of these is compound attribute?
Name.
Which of these is derived attribute? No. If I derive age from this, then this is derived attribute. This is derived attributes, and this is stored data. Date of birth is stored, and from the stored attributes, what we do is we derive some another attribute. Okay. So these are the kind of attributes. In case of simple and compound, simple means an atomic attribute. Atomic means that cannot be further divided. That is atomic attribute. Okay.
Sir, what is difference between composite attribute and compound attribute?
Composite and
compound attributes.
Compound and composite, they are same. This is the name difference between these two things. So we have seen attributes and entity. Then let's look at the relationships. What we mean by relationship? Okay, this need to be understood very carefully, because when we are mapping the ER diagram to tables, this will work. When you minimizing the ER diagram, minimizing the ER diagram to tables, you need to, what we identify is, we have two entities and one relationship. What we try to do is, do we need to have a separate table for relationship or not? So if we can manage to have not a separate table for relation, that means we have minimized. For every table, we should have a, for every entity, we should have a table, but for relationship, we have options. Okay, so we will see what are the cases in which we can actually combine the attributes of a relationship to one of the tables. Okay, that means minimization. So first we will see what is relationship. Let's say we have a relationship that is between employee and department. So what we are doing is, let's say you are with the client and you are sitting with the paper, and he is telling you all the requirements. So he is saying that every department should have an employee, and one department can have more than one employees, and it is possible that one employee is not associated with any department. Okay, so you need to identify what kind of relationship they have. This is relationship, which means employee works for, this is the name of relationships. Okay, we can give any name to relationships. Let's say these are the employees. And these are the departments. In this relationship, we will have the participation of these two entities. Okay, let's say this is relationship one. Any relationship is actually the subset of Cartesian product of these two. Okay, if you take the Cartesian product of these two entities, the relationship will always be the subset of that. Okay, which means E1, D1, E1, D2, E1, D3, all these. Okay, so I'm taking the relationship which is employee E1 works for department D1. Okay, employee E2 works for department D1. Employee 3 works for department D1, like this. So in this, I am doing is, one employee is working for only one department. Now we have few things to observe about this. We need to see the cardinality ratio. We need to see the participation of each entity into the relationship, and we need to see the degree of the relationship. So what is the degree of relationship? Degree equals to 2. Degree means number of entities participating in the relationship. Okay, so this is also binary relationship, which means only two entities are participating in the relationship. So what is cardinality ratio? Cardinality ratio means maximum number of relationships in which any entity is participating. Okay, for example, D1 is participating in how many relationships?
Three.
So the participation ratio of this department is N, and for employee it is
one.
So when you look at the relationship, you will see that if you draw the ER diagram from this, it will be like this: employee works for department, so which will be the many side and which will be the one side? Opposite, which means this will be N side, this will be one side. So what is the difference between card opposite kyun lete hain? When you say the relationship between employee and department, one employee, many employees are associated with one department. So when you look at the relationship, you will say this is many to one. This is many to one. If you read from left to right, if you read from employee to department, you are saying many employees are working for one department. That means relationship is many to one. If you read from the right to left, which means one department should have many employees. Okay, like this. But the participation ratio is actually different. Type of relationship is different and participation ratio is different. Participation ratio means the number of relationship in which one entity is participating. If you look at this, participant ratio will be like this, N, 1. Because employee is participating only in one relationship.
Sir,
but employee participate kar rahe hain. But ek employee ek hi relationship mein participate kar raha hai. One employee is participating in only one relationship.
D5
is empty. We can associate this with someone. So now this is total.
Both
are total. This is one-to-one relationship.
Department ki side total
hai.
Aur aap employee ke side.
Employee ki side bhi hai.
To matlab dono
mein dono mein kar sakte hain.
Sir, ek example de do jisme total na ho.
Isme total na ho. Aapne like DBMS is actually very much related to discrete mathematics. How in relationships, when you say one-to-one and one-to-one onto like this. One-to-one onto means total on both side. ठीक है. On to means कोई ना कोई होना चाहिए, which means in this you cannot have anyone which is not related to this one, but in this you can have an employee which is not related to any department. Into means opposite. Okay, in this you will, all the entities will be associated, but in this all, maybe all the entities are not related. So if I say every employee should be, every employee works for a department, works for some department, and every department should have an employee. This means both side total. If you say every employee is working for a department.
Sir, there's a statement that every employee is working for a department. On the ER diagram, so employee ke side hai na, total participation.
Haan, every jahan pe lagawa na, you say every. This word is important. When you say every employee, which means there all the employee will be associated with any department.
Okay.
Employee ki side total lag gaya.
So fir sir, aur one to many wala bhi bata
do. Ha, wo sare bata rahe hain, abhi wo sab aayenge. Okay. Cardinality ratio or types of relationship mein any doubt? So we have studied all these things. Yes. I'm drawing a diagram and you have to convert this ER diagram to English language. Okay, you will tell me what will be the English language equivalent of this. So anyone, what will be the English equivalent of this ER diagram? Every employee is working for exactly one department. For exactly one department. And any new department may not have any employees. So in case of department, it is partial relationship. Partial means we have a department which is actually a new department in which we do not have any employee. It is possible. Okay, which means this is partial, this is total. When we are saying every employee is related to one department, which means what we are saying is the total relationship is with the employee. Okay, if I say every department should have an employee, which means total side is on the department side. So this relationship is many to one. Many to one means, let us say we have these two entities, that is employee and this is department, and relationship name is works for. What will be the relationships? Let's say employee E1 is working for department D1. Okay. Employee 2 is working for department like this. Okay. So many to one means more than one employee is working for one department. So in this, if you say, what will be the cardinality ratio? Cardinality ratio means the number of relationship in which one entity is participating. If you look at D1, D1 is participating in many entities, in many relationships. Okay, like this. E3, let's say, is working for department D1. E4 is working for department D2. E5 is working for department D3. So this will be the equivalent of this ER diagram. As you can see, some of the departments are empty. They are not participating in the relationship, which means participation of department is partial in the relationship. Participation of employees, all the employees are related to this. So a participation of employees is total. When you draw the tables from ER diagrams, you need to see the total relationship. If there's a total relationship, then you can actually minimize the relationships. But in case of many to many, you cannot minimize the relationship. We will see why we cannot minimize. In that case, we will not have any primary keys. Okay, there will be repeated values.